Well, I'm delighted to be here today with Fotini Hasiotou, a member of the Hartman Human Lactation Research Group at the University of Western Australia. Thank you very much for joining me today.
It's my pleasure.
First of all, on behalf of Medela, many congratulations on winning the AUS Biotech Student Excellence Award earlier this year for your research into stem cells in breast milk.
Thank you.
That is a very significant achievement.
Thank you very much.
So, your research into stem cells is attracting quite some attention, and we're delighted that you'll be giving a first European presentation on your findings at the Medela 7th International Breastfeeding and Lactation Symposium. Ahead of this event, can you give us some brief insights into what has been discovered?
Certainly. We've been looking into the properties of stem cells that the group discovered a few years ago in breast milk, and our aim is to understand their role in the breast during lactation, how they get into the milk, and what are their potential roles for the breast baby. During the last few years, we've been characterizing these cells using a number of different methods and techniques, we have found that they display properties very similar to embryonic stem cells. They're able to self-renew, which is a very important property of stem cells, mm-hmm. but they're also able to differentiate into different cell types, not only breast-specific cells, but also other cell types, such as brain cells, bone cells, liver cells, pancreatic cells, and other cell types. So we'll be presenting these findings at the conference, and we look forward to receiving feedback
fantastic. So where do you think this type of research could lead us in 10 years to live?
We hope to be able to understand the biology of the breast more after 10 years mm-hmm. using the stem cells of breast milk as a model, how it all works, how these cells remodel the breast during pregnancy and lactation to make it a milk secretory organ. Mm-hmm. We're also hoping to understand more the role of these cells for the breastfed baby. There is also the potential to use these cells for stem cell therapies to treat infants with diseases as well as adults. Mm-hmm. So hopefully we will be able to know more in the next few years on this potential. Mm-hmm. And we're also interested in using these cells as a model to understand how cancer happens, what goes wrong to lead to cancer, and how it can be successfully treated. So mm-hmm. Hopefully after 10 years we will have some more answers.
Mm-hmm. Fantastic. Well, thank you very much for your time, and I look forward to seeing you in Vienna.
Thank you very much.